Elvis, the Rolling Stones, Fats Domino, Patsy Cline, those are just a few of the celebrities who had their visits to the Valley captured by the lens of Johnny Franklin, a Valley man who took photos not only of the famous passing through town, but those that lived in the Valley as well. The Sunnyslope Historical Society is hosting an exhibition of Johnny Franklin's photographs and memorabilia. Here to tell us about the life and times of Johnny Franklin is Arizona music historian Johnny D. John Dixon. Good to see you, Johnny.
Nice to see you again, Ted.
Who was Johnny Franklin?
Well, Johnny was the kid backstage with his little Instamatic at just about every show, taking pictures of the known and the not so known. And he was really a young entrepreneur. He would take some of these pictures and turn them into fan club memorabilia, and you could join the fan club of the famous and the not so famous once again. And then probably the most interesting thing, that he just went to so many places, so many venues in the day, and took all of these great pictures of the famous ones, which would go off to Nashville, and he would send them 5-6 copies of the same picture, get an autograph on 3 or 4, they would be sent back to him. And he's just started building this huge archive of photos and negatives and autographs of all of these famous folks.
And we see him here with Wanda Jackson. That is a photo of Johnny Franklin, again, back in the day.
That is in the day.
We have so many things that belong to him. And his business card we have next, and it's an interesting business card in the sense that we see him, we see the name, address, and we see some Wallace and Ladmo folks down there.
Yes, those are, I think, some Kirsten Brothers images. And Johnny, among the other places, he was regularly at the Wallace and Ladmo show. So he created just a wonderful archive of motion picture stars, sports people, just anyone and everyone who would stop by the Wallace and Ladmo show, as well as their regular cast of characters.
I think we have some shots of some live performances from Wallace and Ladmo, again, taken by Johnny Franklin.
Who, right.
And this was, I mean, where is this, Johnny? What are we looking
well,
at?
Well, obviously,
Big John's,
Big
color
John's
TVs?
Wherever his TV was, they did, you know, they did openings. They did every weekend, Ted. They would travel all over, the Wallace and Ladmo show, travel all over the state, and they had different sports teams. They had a football team, a basketball team, a baseball team, all the Ladmo Jets with uniforms. They would play the faculty of these different high schools, and then they do a live show after these different games. They even had a boxing team, and of which all the members, and sometimes some of the Chris DJs, the LaCords would be, but basically it was the cast and crew of the Wallace and Ladmo show. And they tour, they would be in Morenci one night, Prescott the next night, and Ajo, I mean, it was absolutely amazing, Ted.
That looks like Michael Landon there on the left.
That is Michael Landon with Aunt Maud there on the left.
Yes.
And then just one of many stars of the day who stopped by. And then one of my favorite shots, Ladmo back in the alley behind Channel 5 television, just signing autographs for the kids. I don't know whether it's before or after the show, but
sure.
That's just such a candid, wonderful shot, that just the fact that Johnny was there to capture these great moments in Arizona history, it's great.
And we mentioned Wallace and Ladmo and Johnny Franklin and all of his photographs. There was a Wallace and Ladmo coloring book, and some of the, I guess some of the illustrations inside, were, including the cover, were taken were modeled on photographs.
They are modeled on photographs of Johnny Franklin. So Johnny took these various photos of Wallace, Ladmo, Gerald, Aunt Maud out at Legend City. And then someone actually traced them and blew them up to make them the pages of this coloring book. But they were all based on Johnny Franklin photos.
Okay. And obviously, Johnny Franklin, much more than just Wallace and Ladmo. I mean, he basically, if you were in town and he was around, he took a shot. Not only we're talking about, as we mentioned, national and international star, local folks. You mentioned the LaCords.
Yes.
Who are they?
Well, the LaCords were just a great soul group of the time, and they were regulars on the Wallace and Ladmo show besides being performers. There's a great picture of the postcard, and it had Johnny's address on there. You could join the LaCords fan club, and there was everything was 206 East Allis in Sunnyslope, all of these different fan clubs, and they were just a wonderful group at the time. And as I say, they sang on the show as well as being a member of these various teams. And Gene Blue is featured there on the left. Gene is the president, I think, of Phoenix OIC and has been there for many years. So that's Gene on the left. So he's still
he's still around and involved, a member
of the community.
Now, Johnny Franklin also had a, I guess they didn't call him, did they call him fanzines back there? Or was it just a music?
They did. He had a little magazine, he and his brother and a lady by the name of Alice Diaz, who was the editor. They put out a little for about a year called A Closer Look. And there is the cover with the young Linda Ronstadt on this particular cover.
Isn't that something?
And for about a year, these were given out at the Wallace and Ladmo drive-in and then at various advertisers. They sold advertising for all the leather and lace shops on Mill Avenue.
Okay.
And so you could also pick up a closer look there.
That's a great shot of Linda Ronstadt.
It's a great shot. And then he's got a shot. What he would do is then take a picture later, the next time they came up, of that same person holding a closer look, many times with that cover, and showing it, and then he would publish that in A Closer Look.
Well, I think we have Frank Zappa next,
Frank
basically doing what you're talking
doing
about,
exactly
holding,
what,
the
yeah,
cover
he was
himself
very
there.
Pleased to be
he was
holding
always pleased
a closer
with himself.
Look. But Johnny, I mean, he just the energy of this kid and the chutzpah to just go backstage and say, and of course, security was much more lax in those days, Ted.
We talk must more about that. I mean, how difficult would it be to do something like that today?
Well, it would be much harder today. That's what security is for. That's what, you know, you have the venue security as well as the security for the artists themselves. It would be next to impossible without going through tons of paperwork, Ted, talking to the, you know, the promotion agent, the publicity, the management, to be able to do it. And then they have the rights to oversee what you have and approve any and all images. They would be able to do that. In those days, Johnny just took it, published it. Thank you very much.
And in those days, when Johnny Cash came to town and played at the Riverside Ballroom, Johnny Cash was a star.
He was huge.
But he wasn't Johnny Cash quite yet.
No.
And yet, so you could go and look at those shots.
Those are great shots. That's the wonderful Riverside Ballroom.
Where was the Riverside Ballroom?
Well, the Riverside Ballroom is just on the south side, on Central, of the bridge on Central. And for years, you know, they had a swimming pool there, and it was a swimming pool, and then they had an outdoor venue with the flaps on the side, and the venue burned down, and then they built a newer Riverside Ballroom a little closer to Central. But Patsy Cline, Don Gibson, I mean, just all the acts of the day would perform there, and he's got great shots on stage, and then he would always have some candy. He's got some wonderful series of Roy Orbison shots, about eight of them, backstage, reading 16 magazine, calling on the phone, and he was able to get these folks, there's Johnny backstage in the dressing room, get these folks to pose. And then, as I said, Ted, he would send them these pictures in wherever they were, because he's got tons of addresses, and he's got tons of envelopes in his archives that Johnny Cash sent back to Alice with his autographed pictures inside. Johnny, thank you so much for the pictures. Look
just
forward to seeing you the next
fantastic
time.
Fantastic stuff. I want to keep going because there's so much more here. We're not going to get to all of it. But Dick Clark appearing in town. I mean, this looks like, is this the airport? Where is this?
Well, that is actually on the tarmac at the airport. That's Richie Hart on the left, Russi Isabel on the right with the saxophone, and Dick, they're actually standing there on the tarmac welcoming the stars of Because They're Young, because Duane Eddy had done the soundtrack, the music to it. So that was the Arizona connection, Duane Eddy. And so they flew all the stars out here. They had a screening, I think, downtown at the Fox. They did some live music at the Phoenix Indian School bandstand. And that's taken, I think, at the Ramada Inn next to Bill Johnson's Big Apple there on Van Buren.
Which still, so, Bill Johnson's Big Apple,
it,
let's see,
it,
it's still there.
So that's 1960 that Dick came out here.
Wow.
And so Johnny was there to capture that moment.
And he was also at what I think became the Celebrity Theater.
Yes.
But it wasn't the Celebrity Theater then, taking a picture of a band that most definitely became quite famous,
The Grateful
Dead. When is this, Johnny?
Well, this would be 1968, Ted, late 67, 68. And the Travelodge built what became the Celebrity Theater. And I think it was called the Circle Star Theater something originally, but it was a theater in the round. And so he was down there for quite a few shows. And this is just a great, he's got some other great candid shots that we'll have at the exhibition from this same
that
time
is
period.
Remarkable. That
it
is remarkable.
It's great.
Some other big names, Fats Domino, Duane Eddy, here.
Yeah.
All shot by Johnny Franklin.
That particular thing at the Phoenix National Guard Army on 52nd Street. And he was there. And then there's some great Duane Eddy shots, too, of Duane. And he would also take color. Now, there's color. He's playing the Dan Electro guitar, which is rare on that. And just some wonderful live shots there. That's the big roll-up door at the Phoenix National Guard Army. So without his history, Ted, to add to my musical history of records and tapes, this really makes it a complete picture. So I'm honored to have many of these images in my personal collection, and the family has added some for this exhibition we're doing on Sunday.
What happened to Johnny Franklin?
Johnny Franklin, in the end, was one of these guys that would do the weekend, like Greyhound Park thrift shows. And in the end, he was driving to Tucson selling watch bands and watch batteries. And he also had a booth in the grandstand at the Arizona State Fair for years selling posters of country and western stars. He was a big country and western star. He would go to Nashville to the fanfare every year. And even when he was hospitalized in his last year, he would go down to the state fair when they would have the country artist and get backstage to have his picture taken with him. And so he was still befriending many of the country stars, even in his last days.
Okay, but how long did he die?
December the 8th, he passed away.
He passed away December, and he was still going at it, huh?
He was still going at it, 71 years old, and he was always collecting, and his wall in his hospital room was just covered with autographs of his country fans.
Well, John, great work. I'm glad we had you on to help celebrate the life of Johnny Franklin, and we'll talk more about the exhibit, but thank you for being here, man. Good to see you.
Thanks for bringing me down.
All right. So to speak. We're not bringing you down, for goodness sake. You can see more of Johnny Franklin's photographs and memorabilia this weekend. The Sunnyslope Historical Society is hosting the free exhibition, The Life and Times of Johnny Franklin, Sunday, August 12th from 1 to 4 p.m.